These women are out looking for opportunities to grow financially, but being Muslim and who follow Sharia strictly, they can't accept loans that require paying an interest. While households' income remain low in the region, the First Woman Muslim Circle in Hoima City is hoping to change that.
Because we had issues, especially issues to do with interest things. We Muslims, we don't use money that involves interest. And we had to be very, very sure that it is purely Islamic banking. And the microfinance support centers assured us that this time around we are going Islamic banking. And Bunyoro, me as a national leader, I've come to encourage my women in Bunyoro here to embrace the system so that other people also, other districts also, follow suit.
According to the World Bank, people living on less than $2.15 per day fall under the extreme poverty group. The government has initiated several programs to fight poverty at household levels, and many involve loans to support small businesses. So not to leave out these faithful, the Microfinance Support Center is considering extending loans to Muslim institutions free from credit.
Sulaiman Luja, to come up with a very good write-up on how Islamic circles should be well managed and how they should run and how we should fund them. I don't seem to have that. Islamic microfinance, you leave that apart, because now we are starting the business of circles. I wouldn't like to have any circle that breaches any of the laws of Islam. We want to move in that direction.
It's a complex mode of transaction that will take time to succeed at this level. Clerics insist the Microfinance Support Center must honor La Riba rule.
Whatever the case may be, if they compromise with the concepts of riba and the teachings of Islam, we just pull out. That is it. But I'm sure they will not. Because other factors remain constant. If Islam does not allow telling lies, even in financial dealings, we shouldn't tell lies.
Kitara, Emeritus Katikiro, thought it fitting that starting from here, the Muslims should be partake of the cake being distributed directly by Microfinance Support Center.
MSC has already supported them with 100 million shillings, and the main objective of the circle is to empower Muslim women.
Has started with the major objective of empowering Muslim women. Yes. Now, we have the microfinance support center, the one which is launching this, they're the ones giving us support, and they promised us they are giving us 100 million shillings. With the little we have, when we put it together.
With the fear of disobeying Allah in mind, Sheikh Babanja is urging Muslims to embrace government programs.
Invest.
Islamic banking transactions are guided by morals and value systems as derived from the Sharia law, and these demand transparency and full disclosure between parties to the transaction. Good faith in conduct by the parties to the transaction and participation in transactions that do not harm the wider society. Consequently, transactions in Islamic banking are often viewed as a cultural distinct but religiously motivated form of ethical investing. Report by Godfrey Muhumuza for the news.